Hello and welcome back to the Finastra 12 p.m. talk show. Today's guest is a familiar face in the Asian fintech industry. You would have seen her at Money 2020, Singapore Fintech Festival, and in various forums giving insights on the evolution of digital services incumbents in the financial services space. Joining me today is Chandrima Das. Chandrima Das is the CEO of Bento, Asia's first B2B and B2C human-led robo-advisor firm. Chandrima, very lovely to have you, in this episode of the Finastra 12 p.m. talk show. Could we start with you sharing your journey in the industry so far?
So I started in Bombay in the Goldman Sachs equity JV in mid-1990s. And then I have worked in Hong Kong, in Singapore, in London. And then finally, I used to run ING Investment Management in Singapore, mainly on the institutional side. And then with the Bank of Singapore, I used to do fund selection, portfolio construction, and advisory.
What are some of your challenges when you were working with the banks with respect to data sharing or with respect to sort of the regulatory landscape where we see it's quite fragmented?
You know, as a product company, when we go and talk to the banks, we don't tell them this is a solution to get rid of all your RMs. We do not, because that's not what we want to do. So when we go and pitch to a bank, we say this is a technology for your bankers to make them bionic. I mean, I know it's a bit of a cliched word, but we say this is to empower them to take care of 4 to 5 times more clients than they can. So therefore, when we talk to the retail banks or when we talk to the private banks, we don't have bad meetings as such in terms of pitching the product. So we are a product company. We are not a services company. So we go and talk about our product, the benefits, and the benefits caters to a lot of the pain points that the bank has. Then in terms of challenges coming to regulatory, there are two areas. One is places like Indonesia and Malaysia, they do not take cloud-based solution. So we have found ways so that we can do multi-tenanted solution. We have dockerized our solutions so that we can also do part on-prem, part cloud, or entirely on-prem. We are product people. We are not enterprise salespeople, and we lack severely on enterprise sales. So when we reach out to the banks, navigating the banks' procurement department, we find it to be quite challenging.
That's where you see that platform could play a key role in bringing the banks and fintechs like yours together?
I think the next wave that is coming through, which will sustain, is platform as a service. That means rather than me going to X company for doing wealth management, and then I go to maybe M1 to do my bills, and then I go to Grab for my taxi. They would emerge a bit of platform where it is a best of breed of enterprise solution where I can do multiple things. And the first of that we have seen being done by State Bank of India, where they did a campaign called You Only Need One. So you could go to the State Bank of India platform, and you could, right from booking train tickets to getting your credit card, you could do a lot. We see more emergence of that.
That's fantastic. And something in line with that is, if you think about Finastra's FusionFabric.cloud, this is exactly what we're looking at, using our platform to enable banks, fintechs, independent software vendors, academia, technology companies, and universities to all come together and collaborate. What are the two or three tips you would want to give to the upcoming fintechs in Singapore and for them to become successful like yourself and Bento and to scale faster?
If you choose to be a product company, then I would just say that stick to it. It does come through, hopefully.
So sort of stay true to your core.